Now let us start the next topic, visualizing solid shapes. Now what are the solid shapes? So here you are already familiar with some plane figures and some solid shapes in your earlier classes. Now what are the plane shapes? So the plane shapes means which have the only two measurements like length and breadth. The solid shapes are solid objects. So these solid objects have the three measurements like length, breadth, and height. Height or depth. We can give some examples to those figures. Now we can take a rectangle or a triangle or a circle as examples for plane figures, because the rectangle, triangle and circle, they have only the two measurements like length and breadth but no thickness or but no height. So whereas a cuboid, a cube, a sphere, so these objects have the three dimensions like three measurements like length, breadth as well as height. So these objects are called solid objects or solid shapes. Now the plane shapes have only two dimensions, so these plane shapes are called two-dimensional objects. Or simply we can say that 2D objects. And the solid shapes are also called three-dimensional objects. Or simply we can say that 3D objects. Now let us find the whether the following objects are 3D objects or 2D objects. If we consider a rectangle, so this rectangle has only length and breadth. It has only two measurements as length and breadth. So it is a 2D object or two-dimensional object. If you consider a square, so it has length and breadth but no thickness. So it is also 2D object. Now if you consider a triangle, so it is also 2D object, because it doesn't have any thickness. So if you consider a circle, it is also plane figure, so it is also considered as 2D object. Now if you take a cuboid, which have three dimensions as length, breadth and height, now it is considered as a 3D shape or 3D object. Now if you take any cube, so it is also a 3D object. It has length, breadth as well as height. and a cylinder. So it is also a 3D object. Or cone, sphere. So these are also considered as the 3D objects or 3D shapes. In all these figures, the shapes are only single, because here there is only rectangle and here only the square and here only the triangle and only the circle. But in our day-to-day life, we can across some figures like the combination of two different shapes. Now let us see how the combinations of the different shapes will be there. Now let us see the combinations of different shapes. Now in the first figure, so it is a tent, and we can observe that a cylindrical shape, and over the cylindrical shape we can see the conical shape. So this is the combination of two different solid shapes. One is a cylindrical shape and the other is a conical shape. Now a cone surmounted on a cylinder. So there is a cone surmounted on a cylinder. Now if you take the second figure, in the second figure this is a tin. So here this is a cylindrical shell, means this is the combination of two different cylinders. So one is the inner cylinder and the other is the outer cylinder. And if you consider the third figure, so it is a photo frame, means this is nothing but a rectangular path. So in these two rectangles are there, one is outer rectangle and the other is inner rectangle. So this is also the combination of two different shapes. Now the next fourth figure, it is a bowl. So in this bowl, so there are two hemispheres, means it is a hemispherical shell. So one is the inner sphere, inner hemisphere, and the other is the outer hemisphere. So like this we can take the combinations of different shapes. Now let us discuss the next topic, views of 3D shapes. Now three dimensional objects means solid shapes can look differently from different positions, and we can even draw them from different perspectives. Now if you consider a glass, now if you see the side view of the glass, then it is a cylindrical shape. Now if you see the top, means from the upside, then it is looking like two concentric circles, means it is looking like a circular path or a ring. If you consider a brick, means it is looking like a cuboid. Now if you observe the front view of the brick, then it is a rectangular shape, and if you observe the side view of the brick, then it is also a rectangular shape. And if you see the top view of the brick, then it is looking like the rectangular path. Now if you see the top view of the brick, then it is looking like a rectangular path, means one inner rectangle and the other outer rectangle. So we can observe that the 3D objects can look differently from different positions. So there are three possibilities of the positions of the 3D objects. So one is side view, and the second is top view, and the third one is front view. So every 3D object can look from different positions. Now we can combine the cubes and we will get the different solid shapes. Now let us combine three cubes. Now this is a solid, the combination of three cubes. Now here this is the front view and this is the side view and this is the top view. So if you observe the side view, how many cubes are appearing in the side view? So there are two cubes. We can see the two squares from the side view. So we can draw two squares. Here these two squares represent two cubes. So this is the side view. And if you observe the front view, here also there are two cubes. We can observe the two cubes from the front side. So we can look two squares. So this is the front view. Now if you observe the front view, so we can see 1, 2, 3. Three cubes from the front side. So we can draw three squares. So this is front view. And if you observe from the top, so from the top we can find two cubes. So this is a cube and this is a cube. So there are cubes, there are two cubes from the top. So this is the top view of the given solid shape. So from the side view we can see two cubes. So here these two squares represent two cubes, can be seen here from the side, and here three squares from the front, three squares represent three cubes from the front view, and from the top these two squares represent two cubes from the top. Now let us take the combination of four cubes. Now this is a solid shape formed by four cubes, 1, 2, 3 and the fourth one. Now let us see the side view of this solid shape. From the side we can observe the two cubes. So we can draw two cubes, means two squares, to view the side position of the solid shape. So these two squares represent the two cubes from the side position. So this is side view. Now from the front view, from the front we can observe that there are three cubes. So we have to draw three squares. These three squares represent three cubes from the front side. So this is front view. If you observe from the top, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we can find 4 cubes, we can count 4 cubes from the top. So we have to draw 4 squares. So these 4 squares represent 4 cubes, can be seen from the top. So these are the different views of the solid shape formed by four cubes. Now let us see the question. Match for each solid the corresponding top and front views. Now there are three objects given here. So one is water bottle, and the second is a weighing stone of 5 kilograms, and the third one is a cup and saucer. Now if you see the side view of this bottle, so it can appear so like this. So we can match this as a side view of the bottle. And if you see the top view, we can see the two concentric circles. So we can match this to the top view so that we can see the two concentric circles. Now if you take the second object, second 3D object, that is the weighing stone of 5 kilograms, so it is a hexagonal shape, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, six-sided hexagonal shape. So this front view or side view, we can see that. So 1, 2, 3. 3 polygons we can see. So this can be matched with this figure. And if you see from the top, so from the top we can see this shape. So this is given here. So we can match this side view to the top view. From the top we can exactly see the 5 kilograms. Now next, if you take the third figure, cup and saucer, then we can take the side view of this figure, and from the top we can see the three concentric circles, like here two concentric circles and the saucer. So on this thing, so we can match this to three concentric circles. So this is the top view of the cup and saucer. Let us see the next question. Identify for each solid the corresponding top, front and side views. Now there is an almara here. So we can see the front view, the side view and the top view of the almara. Now if you observe the first figure, so then here we can see the front side of the almara. So this can be understood that, so it is a front view. Next, if you see the second figure, now if you see from side, so we can see the rectangular shape, it is looking like, so in the second figure, so we can understand that it is the side view of the Almera. Now if you see the top view, so this top view, again we if you see the from the top also we can observe that it is a rectangular shape, so it is the top view of the Almera. Next, if you consider the television set, so the television set, so this is the front view where screen appears, and this is the side view, and this is the top view. So here the screen is appearing in the first case, so it is the front view of the television set. Now the second case, now it is the side view. We can see the from the side, so we can understand that it is the side view. Next, if you see from the top, so we can see, so this type of shape, so if you see from the top, we can see even the back side of the television set, so that is why this can be written as the top view. So if any object is given, means if any solid shape is given, we can find out and we can draw its front view, top view and side view. Now let us solve the next question. For each given solid, identify the top view, front view and side view. Now here, 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are 4 cubes. So this is the solid shape formed by 4 cubes. So if you see from the side, then we can observe that there are 1, 2, 3. 3 cubes are there, so we have to represent these 3 cubes by 3 squares. Now this is the side view of the given solid shape. Now front view, from the front we can observe that 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 cubes. Now if you see the front view of the given solid shape, so we can find out 1, 2, 3, 4 cubes. So we have to represent these 4 cubes by 4 squares. So these 4 squares represent the 4 cubes can appear from the front side. Now the top view. So if you observe from the top, we can find out only 2 cubes. So we have to draw the 2 squares. Now this is the top view of the given solid shape. Now the second solid shape. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 cubes in the given solid shape. But these 4 cubes are arranged in different manner when compared with the first solid shape. Now in this, so if you see the side view, if you observe from the side, then we can see only 2 cubes. So these 2 cubes are represented by 2 squares in the side view. So this is the side view of the given solid shape. And the next, front view. Now if you see the front of the given solid shape, we can find out 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 cubes. So these 4 cubes are represented by 4 rectangles, 4 squares in the given front view. So 1, 2, 3, then the 4th one is here. So this is the front view of the given solid shape. Next, top view. If you observe from the top, we can see 1, 2, 3. We can observe the 3 cubes. So this is the top view of the given solid shape. Now let us solve the next question. Draw the front view, side view and top view of the given objects. So first figure is a military tent. Now if you see the side view of the military tent, we can observe that it is a rectangular shape. So we can draw a rectangle for the side view. And front view. So if you see the front view, then we can see the triangle is formed here. So the front view is a triangular shape. And top view. So top view, if you observe from the top, we can observe that again a triangle is formed. Next, the second figure. Now if you see the top view, then we get a triangle. Now the second case, a nut is given. So if you see the side view of this nut, then we get a square. And if you see from the top, or if you see from the front, so we can see that this square and these two side squares, so we can see this figure as and if you see from the top, we can observe that, so this hexagonal shape. Next, now there is a dice with holes or with circles given on each face. If you see from the side, we can observe that there is a square with a single circle. And if you see from the front, we can see that this is also a square shape with three circles over on the face. And if you see from the top, so this is also a square which has two circles. So if any solid shape is given, we can show its side view, front view and top view. Now let us go to the next topic, faces, edges and vertices. And some solid figures are polyhedrons and some solid figures are not polyhedrons. Now let us see why these solid figures are said to be polyhedrons and why these solid figures are said to be not polyhedrons. Now if you consider this cuboid, so this cuboid is made up of all polygonal regions, and these polygonal regions means called faces, these will meet in the line segments. So these line segments are edges, and these line segments meet in the corners, means vertices. So these vertices are called points. So this cuboid is made up of all the polygonal regions. So in these polygonal regions, all these polygonal regions are said to be faces of the cuboid. And so all these faces of the cuboid meet in the edges. So these edges are called line segments, and these edges will meet in the vertices. So these vertices are called points. Now here in the second figure also, so this solid shape is formed by the polygonal regions. The lateral faces are like rectangles, and the upper lateral faces are like triangles. So this is also made up of polygonal regions, and so these two figures are said to be polyhedrons. So if you take the स्पीयर, सिलेंडर एंड द कोन. सो दीज थ्री फिगर्स आर नॉट फॉर्म्ड बाय द पॉलीगोनल रीजन्स बिकॉज ए स्पीयर हैज एंटायरली ए कर्व्ड सरफेस. एंड इफ यू कंसिडर ए सिलेंडर, सो इट हैज ए कर्व्ड सरफेस एंड टू सर्कुलर बेसिस. एंड इफ यू कंसिडर ए कोन, सो दिस हैज वन कर्व्ड सरफेस एंड द अदर थिंग इज ए सर्कुलर बेस. सो दिस थ्री फिगर्स डू नॉट हैव द lateral faces as polygonal regions. So these figures are not said to be polyhedrons. Now the next topic is convex polyhedron. Now the convex polyhedron is similar to the convex polygon. Let us see first what is a convex polygon. So if you take any polygon, if it contains any number of sides, if each angle is less than 180 degrees, then it is said to be a convex polygon or closed convex polygon. So this rectangle is a convex polygon. If you take another figure, now this is not a convex polygon because one of the interior angles is more than 180 degrees. So it is not a convex polygon. So we can take even convex polyhedron also the same thing. If each interior angle is equal to or less than 180 degrees, then it is said to be a convex polyhedron. If any interior angle exceeds 180 degrees, then it is not a convex polyhedron. If you observe here, this interior angle exceeds 180 degrees. So this is not a convex polyhedron. Now let us discuss the regular polyhedrons. So what is a regular polyhedron? Now a regular polyhedron is a polyhedron in which all the faces are regular polygons, means all the faces are regular and congruent polygons, and each vertex is formed by same number of faces. See, if you consider this cube, now this is a regular polyhedron. Because it is formed by all the regular polygons, so all the faces are formed by all the regular polygons. Means squares, and each vertex is formed by equal number of faces. See, this vertex A is formed by three faces, and this vertex B is also formed by three faces, like 1, 2, 3. So each vertex is formed by same number of faces. So this is said to be a regular polyhedron. Now let us take the second figure. So it is not a regular polyhedron because so here all the polygon, all the faces are regular polygons, but the vertex A is formed by three faces, but whereas the vertex is formed by four faces. So this is not a vertex A is formed by three faces, whereas vertex B is formed by four faces. So this is not said to be a regular polyhedron. Now let us discuss what is prism and what is a pyramid. So if we consider these two polyhedrons, in these two polyhedrons, the top and base are regular polygons, and if you observe the lateral faces, so these lateral faces are like a parallelogram in shape. So these type of polyhedrons are said to be prisms. So what is a prism? A polyhedron in which the top and base are congruent polygons and the lateral faces are parallelograms in shape. So these two are said to be prisms. Now what is a pyramid? So a pyramid means it is also a polyhedron, but if you observe these two polyhedrons, so the base is a polygon, and if you observe the lateral faces are all triangles, and these lateral faces will meet in a common point called vertex. So here also the base of the polyhedron is a triangle, and all the lateral faces will meet in a common point called vertex. So this type of polyhedrons are said to be pyramids. So what is a pyramid? A pyramid is a polyhedron in which the base is a polygon and the lateral faces will meet in a common point called vertex. Now a prism or a pyramid is named according to the shape of the base. Now here if you consider the second figure, so in this the base of the shape is a triangle, so this is said to be a triangular prism. And if you observe this second figure in this pyramid, then if you observe the base, here also base is a triangular shape, so this is said to be triangular prism. So if the shape of the base is like square, then it is said to be square prism. Or if the shape of the base is a regular hexagon, then it is said to be a hexagonal pyramid. Let us consider a cuboid, a triangular prism and a triangular pyramid, and let us count the number of faces, vertices and edges of each polyhedron. So first we will take cuboid. So in a cuboid, how many faces are there? So if you consider a cuboid, there are four lateral faces and top and base. So totally there are six faces. And how many vertices are there? So if you count the vertices of the cuboid, so here on the top 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 vertices. On the base 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are totally 8 vertices in a cuboid. And how many edges are there? So if you count the edges of the cuboid, so on the top 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 edges on the top, and on the base 4 edges, and by side again there are 4 edges. So 3 fours are 12 edges in a cuboid. Then let us add number of faces and the number of vertices. So we get 6 plus 8 equals to 14. Then E plus 2. So how many edges are there in the cuboid? So there are 12 edges. So if you add 12 plus 2, this equals to 14. So here we got F plus V equals to E plus 2. So if you consider a cuboid, a regular polyhedron, then the sum of number of faces and the number of vertices is equal to the sum of the number of edges and 2. So the result is said to be Euler's formula. Now let us check whether the Euler's formula is true in case of triangular prism and triangular pyramid or not. Now if you consider triangular prism, first you will count how many faces are there. So in a triangular prism, there are 3 lateral faces and top and base. So totally there are 5 faces. And how many vertices are there? The number of vertices on the top 3 vertices and on the base 3 vertices. So totally 6 vertices are there in a triangular prism. And how many edges are there? The number of edges, 3 edges on the top and 3 edges on the base, 3 plus 3, 6, and 3 edges on the lateral faces. So totally 9 edges in a triangular prism. Now let us find the sum of F and V. 5 plus 6 equals to 11 and E plus 2. So what is E value in case of triangular prism? 9. So 9 plus 2 equals to 11. So here also we get F plus V equals to E plus 2. Now let us consider triangular pyramid. So in the triangular pyramid we will count the number of faces. So 3 lateral faces and only the base. So totally there are 4 faces in a triangular pyramid. Now how many vertices are there? So there are 3 vertices on the base and the top one vertex is there. So totally there are 4 vertices in a triangular pyramid. And how many edges are there? So 3 edges on the lateral faces and 3 edges to the base. So 3 plus 3, 6 edges in case of triangular pyramid. Now again we will find the value of F plus V and the value of E plus 2. So F plus V, F value is given that 4 plus V value we got 4. 4 plus 4 equals to 8. So then E plus 2 value, E value is 6 plus 2 equals to 8. So here also we got F plus V and E plus 2 same. So here also we can write that F plus V equals to E plus 2. So this formula is known as Euler's formula. So this is true for in case of any regular polyhedron. Now let us solve few problems. Can a polyhedron have for its faces 3 triangles? Now let us check whether a polyhedron is possible having 3 faces. So if you take any polyhedron with 3 triangular faces, it is not possible because there is no polyhedron having 3 lateral faces. So we cannot form any polyhedron with 3 triangular faces. Now with 4 triangular faces, yes, a polyhedron can be formed with 4 triangular faces. Next, a square and 4 triangles. We can form a polyhedron with a square base and 4 triangular faces, means lateral faces. So that is like a square pyramid. So we can form a polyhedron with a square base and 4 triangles as the lateral faces. So here we can write yes. Next, the next question, is it possible to have a polyhedron with any given number of faces? Yes, we can form a polyhedron with any given number of faces, but the number of faces must be greater than or equals to 4. Then only we can form a polyhedron. So we can write that it is possible, but the number of faces is greater than or equal to 4. So to form a polyhedron, the minimum number of faces must be 4, or you can take more than 4. Next, the next question, how are prisms and cylinders alike? So when a prism becomes a cylinder, actually if you consider a prism, the lateral faces are like parallelograms or rectangles. But if you consider the cylinder, the lateral surface, the lateral face is a chord face. So if you increase the number of sides of the base, then the prism becomes a cylinder. So as you increase the number of sides of the base of a prism more and more, then it becomes a cylinder. So we can write that a prism becomes a cylinder if the number of sides of its base becomes larger and larger. So as you increase the number of sides of the base of a prism indefinitely, means infinitely, then the prism becomes a cylinder. Now the next question is, how are pyramids and cones alike? Here the pyramid means, here also the pyramid also has the lateral faces like a triangular shape, and but the lateral face of a cone is a curved face. So the pyramid may be any pyramid, the based on the shape of the base, it may be triangular pyramid or it may be square pyramid or it may be pentagonal pyramid. But if you increase the number of sides of the base, then at last, means if you increase the number of sides of the base infinitely, then the pyramid becomes a cone. So here also we can write that a pyramid becomes a cone if the number of sides of its base becomes larger and larger. Now let us see the next question. Which are the prisms among the following? So the first figure is a nail. Now first, what is the definition of a prism? So when a polyhedron is said to be a prism, means when a solid shape is said to be a prism, so if it has two congruent bases, means top and base are congruent to each other, and the lateral faces must be parallelograms. But if you consider the nail, so it doesn't have the two congruent bases, means the top and the base are not congruent to each other. So your top is a circular shape, but whereas the bottom is a point. So, and even the lateral faces are not like parallelograms, means the lateral face of a nail is a curved face. So it is not said to be a prism. It is not a prism. Next, if you consider the second figure, it is an unsharpened pencil. So if you consider the top and bottom, two bases, so these two bases are congruent and these two are regular polygons. So it is a regular hexagon, and even the top also a regular hexagon, and these two are congruent faces. And what about the lateral faces? So these are all actually rectangles, means we can consider the lateral faces as parallelograms. So it is said to be a prism. So we can write that it is a prism. Next, the third figure. It is a table weight, but it is looking like a pyramid, and yeah, the top is a vertex, whereas the bottom is a polygon, means the base is a polygon, but the top is a vertex, and even the lateral faces are not like parallelograms. So the lateral faces are triangular in shape. So this is not a prism. So we can write that next, a box. So this is nothing but a cubic box, because all the lateral faces are in the shape of square, and even the top and base are also in the shape of a square. So your top and base both are regular polygons and congruent to each other, and the lateral faces are like squares, means we can consider them as the parallelograms. Now we can say that it is a prism. Let us take the next question. Is a square prism same as a cube? Explain. So a prism is named according to the shape of the base. If the shape of the base of a prism is a square, then it is said to be a square prism. Or if the shape of the base of a prism is a pentagonal shape, then it is said to be a pentagonal prism. So now let us draw a square prism. Now this is a square prism because the shape of the base and top, so both are squares. But now it is said to be a cuboid but not a cube because the length and width are not same. So if a square prism is there, then it may be a cuboid but not compulsory a cube. So we can write the answer as no, it can be a cuboid. Now next question, can a polyhedron have 10 faces, 20 edges and 15 vertices? Now let us check, is there any polyhedron so with the given 10 faces, 20 edges and 15 vertices. So when it is said to be a polyhedron, if it satisfies the Euler's formula. Now let us check whether this polyhedron satisfies the Euler's formula or not. A number of faces equals to 10 and number of vertices equals to 15 and the number of edges equals to 20. Now we will find the value of f plus v. So this equals to 10 plus 15 equals to 25. Now e plus 2 equals to e value is 20 plus 2, so this equals to 22. But here f plus v is not equal to e plus 2. Means the given polyhedron does not satisfy the Euler's formula. So we cannot form a polyhedron with 10 faces, 20 edges and 15 vertices. Therefore we can write that a polyhedron cannot have 10 faces, 20 edges and 15 vertices. So let us take the next question. Verify the Euler's formula for the solid given below. Now if you observe the base or top of this solid given here, so it is a pentagonal shape, so it is a pentagon. Now it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sides. Now what is the number of faces of this solid? So f equals to, from each side of this pentagonal base, one lateral face is there. So there are 5 sides, so 5 lateral faces and base and top. So 5 plus 2, 7 faces are there. Next, number of vertices. Let us find how many vertices are there in the given solid. In the base 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and in the other base again 5. So totally 5 plus 5, 10 vertices are there. So there are 10 vertices in the given solid and you will find how many edges are there. Number of edges. So at the top 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 edges and even in the base also 5 edges and 5 lateral edges. So totally 5 plus 5 plus 5. Totally 15 edges are there. Now let us find the value of f plus v. According to Euler's formula, we should verify that whether f plus v equals to e plus 2 or not. Now first we will find the value of f plus v. Here f value is 7 plus v value is 10. So this equals to 7 plus 10 is 17. Then we will find the value of e plus 2. So your e value is given that 15 plus 2 equals to 17. So then we get both f plus v value and e plus 2 value are same. So we can write that f plus v equals to e plus 2 means the given solid satisfies the Euler's formula. Now we will solve the next question. Using the Euler's formula, find the unknown. So in the given table, the faces, vertices and edges of the solid shape are given that. So in the first case, we have to find the number of faces, but in this case the number of vertices is 6 and the number of edges is 12. So whereas in the second case, the faces are 5, we don't know the vertices, and the edges are 9. So in the third case, the faces are 12. So in the third case, the faces are 20, the vertices are 12, then you have to find the number of edges. So we know that Euler's formula. F plus V equals to E plus 2. So if you consider any polyhedron, it must satisfy the Euler's formula as F plus V equals to E plus 2. Now if you take the first question, so we have to find the number of faces, so F value question mark, then the number of vertices V equal to 6 and the number of edges E equals to 12. So if you substitute these values in the given formula, F plus V equals to E plus 2, then F value we don't know, F plus V is 6 equals to E value is 12 plus 2, then F plus 6 equals to 12 plus 2 is 14, then F equals to, by transposing plus 6 to RHS, then it becomes minus 6, so we get 14 minus 6. So then F equals to 8. So the number of faces in the first case is 8. And the second case, here the number of faces is given, F equals to 5. And we have to find the number of vertices. So V equals to question mark. We don't know how many vertices are there. Then we will find the then number of edges is given that 9 equals to 9. Now we will substitute these values in the Euler's formula. F plus V equals to E plus 2. Then F value is 5 plus V equals to E value is 9 plus 2. So then 5 plus V equals to 9 plus 2 is 11. Then V equals to 11 minus 5, V equals to 6. So the number of vertices in the second case is 6. Now let us consider the third case. In this, number of faces is given that 20. And the number of vertices is also given, it is 12. And we have to find the number of edges. So E equals to question mark. So let us substitute these values in the Euler's formula. F plus V equals to E plus 2. So here F value is 20 plus V value is 12. Equals to, so E value we don't know, let us write the same as E plus 2. Now 20 plus 12 is 32 equals to E plus 2. Now we can write that E plus 2 equals to 32, then E equals to 32 minus 2, so therefore E equals to 30. So the number of edges in the third case is 30.